and against Judah and against all the inhabitants of Jerusalem. This is his people. This is God talking to his people. I love God. God ain't gonna do nothing. I will cut off every trace of Baal from this place. The names of the idolatrous priests with the pagan priests. What did he say? Idolatrous priests. Priests who have been into witchcraft. Oh, come on now. Preachers who are rebellious. You see, when I have a spirit of rebellion, I'm idolatrous. Amen. Because I don't want to do what God sent me to do. I want to do what I want to do. Who did you make an idol? You made yourself an idol because you want to do what you want to do. You look at American Idol, you think it's another person, but really, have you made yourself an idol? Because he said, because you were rebellious and would not do it, would not heed, would not hear what the word of God was saying, you have become an idolatrous. So I can be a man of God and not preach the word of God. But let me just preach you a good message. Everything is good. Be encouraged, everybody. Y'all send your money now to me. Amen. In the name of Jesus Christ. And don't teach you or preach to you the truth. And then you fell into a trap. He says, I will take care of the idolatrous priest and the pagan priest. He said, there's no difference from you being an idolatrous priest, from you being one that's rebellious, that won't teach the people, won't preach to the people, will not tell the people again what sin can bring into them, won't talk to them the truth. It's no different between you and a pagan priest. It's no different between you being a priest, or being a man of God, hallelujah, that won't stand for anything, but wear the title. You're just as wicked as the person I did that don't even know me. You're just as wicked as the person that's the voodoo worker and the black natural. But you're just as wicked as they are. And I'm going to remove both of you. Those who worship the host of the heavens on the housetop, and those who worship and swear oaths by the Lord, but who also swear by the hilltop. Amen. What are you swearing by? Those who have turned back from following the Lord and have not sought the Lord, nor inquired of him. Don't you know it's worse for a person to start out and say that you know the Lord, again, for a person who never knew him? Don't you know that you can't start out knowing the Lord and you can't back this train up? He will bring more judgment upon you, the one who started the race, and said, God, give me an opportunity. And I know you've been there, because I've been there. Amen. Lord, if you just get me out of this situation, I'll serve you. But then you find yourself with your mind following your eyes. And you look back. But you didn't try to denounce God. You didn't try to denounce him. But at the same time, what you did was you allowed him to be on the back burner. And God ain't going to be on the back burner for nobody. You could not put big God and God beside each other. They tried it. And they found out the big God was broken in pieces. Because you cannot set what is of God beside that what is of God. You cannot put what is unclean. Amen. Hallelujah. And I'm saying to you, no, don't get me wrong. You don't walk around like an idol. You don't walk around like everybody is dirty. No. Don't get that wrong. Because you're supposed to go after people. But you're going to have to continually stay in the Word. Because the Word is what's going to cleanse you. Be silent. And look what he says. Those who have turned back from following the Lord and have not sought the Lord nor inquired of him. Be silent in the presence of the Lord God. For the day of the Lord is at hand. For the Lord has prepared a sacrifice, and he has invited his guests. And you say, what do you mean by he's got a sacrifice? It's you. You're the sacrifice. He prepared his son Jesus to be nailed to the cross. And you think that he ain't going to prepare you, that you proclaim it to know God, and you proclaim it. That's why you have to watch yourself. As Robert was saying earlier, you got to watch yourself, because especially now, if you turn your back on God, he will stretch you out. And people will preach your funeral. And some people will get saved because he stretched you out. And it shall be in that day of the Lord's sacrifice, and I will punish the princes and the king's children. All of such a clothed with foreign apparel. Who did you go a whoring after? And what did you bring home with you? What's on you that shouldn't be on you? Is it lust? I don't have the lust of spirit. But the first person that looked pretty good, and you think that that person was sent to you by the Lord, and the devil don't look at everybody that you looked at for the last 10 years, so the devil know your type. You think God is the only one that knows? Don't smell good, look good, walk good, but ain't gonna be good for you.
Because see, what you did was you put on some foreign apparel. Yes. See, you took off the garment of what God gave you, that you're going to worship, you're going to pray, you're going to magnify the God. You know, God, please send them to me, God, I got to have them. And then they almost killed you. Because you hit on the wrong apparel. You took off the shield of faith. Yes. Amen. Amen. And put on the shield of imitation. Let me leave this thing alone. And the same day I will punish all those who leap over the thresholds, who fill their masters' houses with violence and deceit. Is your heart violent? Is it strifeful? Are you deceitful? Will you lie as quick as, again, a net can be swatted? Will you lie? Oh, God, deal with us, y'all. What lie did you tell last week? Let me change that. What lie did you tell yesterday? And there should be on, what lie did you tell this morning? And there should be on that day, says the Lord, the set of a mournful cry for the fish cake, and wailing from the second quarter, and a loud crashing from the hills. Well, it would happen so much, Tesh, for all the merchants people are cut down, and all those who have the money are cut. He's trying to tell you, stop looking so hard for the money. It's not going to matter. I had $28 million at one time in assets. I did say 20 and 8. But it got down to the point that I had less than a million. He peeled me like an onion. Because he's looking, he said again, don't chase after the money more than you chase after me. And I can work 40 hours a week. And I spend it 40 hours with him. You said that's impossible. I mean, but do you pray in the morning? Is your soul praying at night? Prayer to shift and believe. Do you get up and pray, or do you just get up and eat? Do you pray when you have your food? Do you say grace? Everybody's around you, but you don't look at people, so you ain't gonna say grace because
you don't want to pay them.
Right. You want to be politically correct. Actually, what you want to be is deadly correct. Well, I can't pray on my job. You can pray silently. You want to be having a conversation with God. If you have a conversation with God, God will have a conversation with you.
Amen.
But you will have to have one with him.
Yes.
And you can't do a hit and miss. Don't you know that the same God that allowed me to amass 28 million? Now don't get me wrong, I dedicated every building to God. Did all the right things. Amen. Dedicated every building. Consecrated to the Lord. And he blessed my hands. But there comes a time that you need to realize that all you need is God. And when you realize that God is all you have, you realize he's all that you need. He can give you a house when others say you can't have it. He can get you a car when the one you got is broken down. He can get you a job when they say that again, your weapon's going to stop you from getting a job. Because he is the giver. Fall in love with the giver.
Yes.
Not me.
Yes.
Let me. Right now in this country, this is what's going to get this country right now. And I'm going to hit it real hard. This is what's wrong with this country. We're chasing after the dollar.
Uh-huh.
I'll sell you out for the dollar.
Oh,
I'll sell you out. Give me $10,000 and you're on the job, and they tell me we're going to give you $10,000, but we don't need prayer no more. I said, how do you want me to get rid of it? That's the attitude of the people.
Yes.
That's where we are. Trip you up because they want what you got.
Yes.
And I'm trying to tell you now, well, this is where this country has become. This country has gotten into the part again is, even when they don't care about school system.
No.
It's about the money. Where can I get a write-off? Where do you think all these people lie about all the attributes of their children going to school?
That's right.
And they weren't true.
Yep.
Paid millions of dollars.
Yes.
Because it's about prestige. It's about pride.
Yes.
It's about what can money buy you. Because we have began to fall in love with money. Why do you think Why do you think this country has positioned itself and gave all these trillions of dollars to the rich folks? Why do you think that again, that these rich people again, that they found out and they had a hypothesis that if you don't give a tax break to these people, that they ain't gonna spend no money? Well, if you make the tax code the way it's supposed to be, they'll spend the money rather than me paying the taxes. There is a tax credit for hiring people. So you want to keep your money? Create more jobs. And truth be known, what they found, I'm going to stop getting political, but we have sold ourselves out. We've been hoodwinked and blamed, and we fell for it. Amen. You cannot keep having the millions of dollars in debt that we have. Trillions. And that we're not going to pay for it. Who's going to pay for it? My children, or either my grandchildren. But they got to pay for it. You can't have a debt that's canceled. Only God can cancel a debt.
Yes.
Let me leave that alone. That's my editorial. And it shall come to pass at that time that I will search Jerusalem with lamps and punish the mean. Somebody been raising hell at you? Hush. Who are settled in that complacency, who say in their heart, the Lord will not do good, nor will he do evil. But I'm here to tell you, they laughed at you. And say, God ain't going to do nothing. We're back to next. We don't hear him judge. God ain't going to do nothing. But I'm trying to tell you right now, the Lord is looking for my enemies with a lamp. He's looking for yours with a lamp. It ain't going to hurt. They can hide. They can go up under the doorstep, but they still won't be low enough. They can go in the closet, but they cannot hide. They can go up on the rooftop in the attic, but they cannot hide. Because there's a lamp coming. For the people who did you wrong.
Jesus.
You do the right thing.
Yes.
And you're going to watch what's going to happen. I don't care what lie they told. I don't care what lie they told you. I don't care what lie they told to the public. But there's a day of reckoning that is coming.
Yes.
For this nation and for the people again who did unto you. You ain't got to worry about vengeance because the Lord said vengeance is mine. You ain't got to worry about who stole from you because the Lord said count 1,000 years is mine. I can replace, I can restore, I can establish, I can move you up into the pathway of your success. You're going to have to listen to what I say, and you're going to have to follow my instructions, amen. And you are not going to have to forget who you are and what I brought you out, because of the weakness of the children, because here he's talking to them. I brought you out of Egypt, but you decided you wanted to go out. I brought you, I gave you a car, but you still can't find time to drive it to my house. I gave you a house, but it's not dedicated to me.
Come
on. Shut up, what I share. He's dealing with the child. He's dealing with us. He's dealing with us. Help me, Holy Ghost.
Yeah.
Therefore, that girl should become booty and their houses of desolation. I didn't say it, the word said.
Yeah.
They should get houses but not inhabit them. They should plant vineyards but not drink that wine. There's somebody, help me, Holy Ghost. Don't worry about what it is. Amen. For yes, I rode by. I rode by and I see some people. Amen. I can't even think of one house that they're in. Help me, Holy Ghost. That it belongs to mine because the rest of them are still waiting for me to come back to you in the name of Jesus. And I believe that the Lord will raise up, hallelujah, for you. Whatever the dead thing is, if you keep giving to God, you say yourself to God. Let me tell you something. Some of the things you lost, you don't want that. Because what God is going to bring you, it's better than what you want.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. He's trying to move you out of the vineyard. Because the vineyard that you had was too small. He's trying to move you out of the house because the house that he's bringing you to is bigger and greater than what you had. Let me talk this thing together again. The great day of the Lord is near. It near and hastens quickly. It's coming quickly. Say it again. If you can see it, if you can believe it, if you can trust God, you don't have to be a moron, a scientist, but you will be a moron if you don't believe that we are closer to the day of God's reckoning. This country, amen. How in the world can you have this many mass murders in 1 week? In 1 week. The great day of the Lord is near. It is near and hastens quicker. The noise of the day of the Lord is bitter. Then a mighty man shall cry out. The day is a day of wrath. And you wonder about God's return. This is when you have to equate Psalms 91 to be able to live with this song. With what, again, Zephaniah is saying. A 1,000 to the left and 10,000 to the right, but it will not come in your dwelling. Tormentor will come down the street and skip your house.
But God's wrath is getting ready to come upon the face of the earth. A day of trouble and distress, a day of devastation and desolation, a day of darkness and gloom. He's talking about the day of the Lord. He's talking about before the Lord God returns. This didn't happen with Jesus Christ. Even though this is the Old Testament, this is a word that has been spoken again by Zephaniah the prophet to be able to tell people that what is coming and the doom and the gloom and that judgment that is getting ready to come upon the nation. A day of clouds and thick darkness. A day of trumpet and alarm against the fortified cities and against the high towers. You think that you hear sirens? You're going to hear more sirens. Amen? Maybe the reason why we're here in Yanceyville. Prophecy was spoken that Carolina Public Studios would become the gospel entertainment capital of the world. That word was spoken in 2000. Amen.
Amen.
And you begin to say, how can it become more bigger than New York or LA? Because neither one of those cities may exist.